When I was in college, I lived in Spain for a semester and I traveled around Europe a little bit. And actually after high school, I did some travels in Europe. And whenever I would go into a Catholic cathedral, I would just feel moved. It was just so majestic and so overwhelming to the soul. And I always kind of chalked it up to I'm feeling nostalgic, although I never went to a church like that in Ohio or Oklahoma, so I'm not sure why I thought that. But definitely, I think beauty worked on my soul in a way that was kind of skipped the intellect and just went to my heart and worked on me in a very subtle way. When I was in Costa Rica, a man came up to me and said, "Teresita, isn't it a beautiful day? Thank God for this beautiful day." And I was like, "It's a beautiful day, but I don't have anyone to thank for it." So part of me, I think, was kind of proud of that. You know, like I don't have to thank anyone for it. It's just beautiful. It just is what it is. I don't know if beauty can move your reason to comprehend that there's a God, although, you know, Thomas Aquinas would probably say so in terms of seeing goodness, like God is the highest quality of goodness. So seeing beauty, there has to be this beautiful kind of paradigm of beauty against which we compare all beauty, because everyone has it in their mind that they're seeing beauty, but then where do we even get this concept of beauty? And when we see beautiful things, there's always like something even more beautiful than that. But I think it's a very subconscious thing. I think that is why it is such a powerful tool of evangelization, because I think that we need to move people on a level that kind of gets them in the gut, you know, like, and I think beauty is one of those things. I think humor is. I think humor can kind of dip below the intellect and you get the joke if you understand it, kind of, it's kind of skipping under your reason, but you are also reasoning if you get the joke. So I think there are different ways to kind of skip under all of those barriers that we put around our reason, kind of walls around our reason to only reason in certain ways. And I definitely think beauty is one of them. I think I made steps, and intellectually, like the step with believing in the immortal soul, believing that human life was more valuable than animal life, all those things. I think I made steps probably through the grace of God. But then there came a moment where I think my reason just wasn't capable of, especially in terms of church teaching, reasoning without the grace of God. I really needed the grace of God to do that, because my reason was so hampered by all these different things. I felt after coming back to the church and receiving the grace of reconciliation and the grace of communion, I felt like it liberated my reason. I was able to kind of think in all these different ways that I just had not allowed myself to think before.